Well, the crack's sealed up. The glue is holding it together.
But we need to go inside and fix this cleat thing. Yeah, it looks like they tried to fix it, but they missed the mark. So, I've got
some rare earth magnets here, which are your friend. And I will now show you what I make repair cleats out of. You can use a solid piece. But then what has to happen is you have to make sure that you orient the grain. The grain orientation is such a way that it's not going to split where the crack was, right? But, you see, this is not a solid piece. This is tiny plywood, which has opposing grain on the inside. So it's not that critical. You can just sort of cut your little diamond shape. This stuff comes from the hobby shop, where they make, you know, wooden model airplanes and stuff. Anyway, I'll get the saw out, cut myself a couple of diamond shapes, and make some cleats. My little cleats. Next, my magnets. This is where you'll get balled up and make a mess. So I need to identify what sides stick together. Excuse me. So put a little magic marker mark on that, and those are the sides I want to see. Alright, so now I'm going to get this guy in the position that I believe it needs to be, which is going to be right about there. Then we're going to tape that in position. Right. Like that. So when I go to slip that inside, this doesn't come flying in the wrong direction towards the other magnet, right? Next tiny magic trick. Take a tiny piece, and I mean a very tiny piece of double-sided tape. Tiny little piece, because I know this stuff is the best. And then back to the side I want to see. That's got to go in like that. So you got to think about it, otherwise the magnet's going to flip around on you. And that might even be more double-sided tape than I really need. Of course it's going to come flying at the razor blade. Right, that, see, that stuff's sticky, so, but it won't be as sticky as this is going to be in a minute. Take the backing off of this and stick it to the cleat. Then we're going to put glue on the cleat and stick my long skinny arm up in there, and it's going to go snap right in the right spot. So the other thing that'll happen is I got my good mirror and some good light inside there. Is once I sink this, I can use the magnet on top to move it around a little bit. That's going to be tons. Carefully. You can do it, Dave. Sure. Move over just a little bit more. That's that. Once the glue dries, I remove the magnet from the top, I'll be able to go in and just pop that other guy off of there. Okay, for my next magic trick, I'm wondering if there should be one even further back. The other guy
That was really rough on my wrist. I didn't like that much. The other guy needs to go there. My magnet in place. Do the same drill. Yeah, okay. There's that little piece of tape I had. This one will be easier on my wrist. I don't have to... See, this is where child labor comes in handy. You have tiny arms and hands and stuff. That's a pile. Put the cap back on. Don't be that guy. All right. In we go. There it is. I gotta look. That's that. Like I said, I'm thinking there should be a third one. There. And I gotta find some more magnets. And that's sort of that. I guess I'm gonna wait for glue to dry. And then we'll clean this thing up. Give the fretboard some help. Bridge is really dry as well. I mean, I did humidify this guitar. And I used this little Inkbird guy, which is really cool. Because with the app on my phone, I can read the humidity directly inside of the guitar. So when I started out humidifying this thing, it was sitting at about 30%, which is borderline. The humidity in my house is usually above 40. I like it to keep it at 50, but it gets really difficult when the furnace kicks in and it gets really cold. Today I'm looking at humidity. I've got a temperature sensor and humidity sensor that tells me what everything's doing all over the house. So because the furnace is here in the basement, the humidity is the lowest. And I should correct that really, but I don't store guitars down here anyway. I just work on them. So we got 53% on the main floor, 50% upstairs in the master bedroom, 68 degrees and 48% in the TV room. And that's sort of that. But anyway, this is a cool little invention. I really like using it for this sort of stuff. So let's let the glue dry and then I'll get strings on it and see what happens. It's going to be fine. Okay, I'll stick my hand inside this thing one more time. Get my magnets back. And then let's put strings on it. Well, no, we got to clean it up. It's pretty grubby. A little bit of Fret Eraser action here. Find out where those are. They're under there. Covered in a layer of crust. My goodness, I think this is going to be a job for Simple Green. Ugh. Oh yeah, and always remember, if you're going to do a little oil treatment to your rosewood, don't forget the rosewood bridge. Those dry out more than anything. Fingerboard gets oil from your fingers. Doesn't take much. In fact, whatever's left on the cloth, and this isn't a cloth, it's a paper towel. Get you guys in the movie there. Right. Right. Clean up the rest of it and find some strings. So I'm told, you know, hey, there's a new set of strings in the case. Yeah, well, sorry, boss. These are for a classical guitar. what we're going to use are those. You know, I can't win for losing to sometimes, just like, leave no stone unturned. And yeah, let's deal with this.
Well, it's tuned up.
String action looks really nice. Don't have to bother fooling around with that. Why can I never find what I want when I want it? That sounds like a song title. Where did that go? I just had it. Found it. What do we got for neck relief? I'm not even going to play with that. That seems fine to me. I never checked to see if the electronicals worked, because the battery was dead. Okay, what is this? Oh, it's an LR bag. LR bags equipped. Oh, does it make sound? I think it's got one of them fancy built-in tuners and everything. Or maybe it doesn't make a noise, I don't know. I'm not hearing anything. Well, the tuner lights up. Or does it? Sure it does. Why don't we hear sound? I hear a little clicking. Sucks, doesn't it? Mode, tuner, phase. Seems like it wants to. Okay. It's not why it was here, but I'll have to have a look. So, you know, like I said, this was not here for this issue. Open this up and see if something I see that I can fix. But if the tuner works, does that work off the little pickup, or is it just got its own little thing in there that picks up noise? I guess I could pop that preamp out and have a look at that, make sure it's all plugged in. But after that, there are no serviceable parts in there that I can deal with. So this guy slides out. Now, it might slide out, it might not. Nope, because the wires are cinched inside. Let's just see what we see here. Well, I don't see no damages. Flip it over, just look at that switching jack. Because I can. Tools everywhere. Well, see, it's this little circuit board mounted thing, so just plug it in. So plug it in, wiggle things around, see if we can get something to happen. And if the tuner works, that means it's getting power. Pop this little preamp out the end and see if I can figure it out, but otherwise I'll have to just give the bad news. Oh, some days I'm good. There's a little plug, tiny, you know, plug that plugs in the preamp, and I don't know, I got it sort of pulled out. Makes me happy. That's sort of that, folks. Nothing left to do but clip off the strings. I just got a brand new batch of stickers. Oh wait, I should pause and show you something really cool. I'm gonna do that, give me a minute. My friend Scott, who makes the fabulous Dave's World of Fun Stuff stickers, is getting into the t-shirt gag. These are high quality shirts with a really nice high quality screen on them. So that's cool, because now I think we'll do some shirts and we'll figure it out. Scott can do some small runs, right? So in the next month or so, I'm gonna think about that. All the links to other things are below. Sorry, no shirts right now. That's my shirt. Yeah, right. Like Led Zeppelin wears their own t-shirts, right? I don't know, maybe they do. Does Steven Tyler wear an Aerosmith shirt? I don't know. I don't have answers to these questions. Anyway, folks, thanks for hanging out. Once again, the links to things that we love are below. Special shout out to all my patrons, Facebook group people, Twitter people, subscribers, all the folks out there. Take care. Be good to each other. Stay safe. Cheers.